Hey everybody, it is a little bit late for us, so if we look like a mess, that's why. But welcome back to another Taste Test Tuesday, and we're going to try something that's not actually that exciting, but we don't really have anything.
I mean, we could always just eat the Wendy's Baconator chips again.
No. Okay. We are trying a gluten-free pumpkin spice cake mix. Well, not the mix, the cake. We've already made the cake. We like to make pumpkin spice cakes. They're pretty good. This is a cake mix made by Pillsbury, and this year, or I don't know if it's new or not, but I just happened to see it, they're offering a gluten-free version. My mom has celiac disease, so I've kind of, at least through half of my life, grown up with gluten-free stuff. Anytime we make something like that the whole family's gonna eat, it has to be gluten-free friendly. So I've had my share of gluten-free foods, and it's a hit or miss. Unfortunately, the breads are always terrible. Like, legitimately, they're just awful. But there are foods that are really good. There is a pancake mix that we actually eat regularly that is gluten-free because it's just so good. And gluten-free is just better for you anyway. I decided to try the gluten-free version versus the regular version because I was curious what it tasted like. We also have cream cheese frosting because that's, like, literally so good. So that's what we put in there. I attempted to make kind of like a double stack or like two layer cake, and it doesn't look too good, but whatever, it's gonna taste good. Do you want me to try first, or do you want to try first?
I don't want to try first.
It's very moist, I can tell you that much, because it was not sticking together very well. Is it good?
Yeah, yeah.
Can you tell it's not gluten, I guess?
I don't know.
Does it taste weird, or does it just taste normal?
Tastes normal, can't discern the difference. If I didn't know any better, it still had glutes.
There is something different about it. I don't know what it is that they put in there, but, and I think this is probably only something that you would necessarily notice if you eat a lot of gluten-free food. There's this taste, and it is not very noticeable. It's probably because I'm looking for it. There's this taste. It can be good or it can be bad. Fortunately with this, it is good. It doesn't ruin it. It doesn't stand out too much. Like, it's not super noticeable, so I could eat this and really it wouldn't bother me. I just noticed it because, yeah, I'm looking for it. It tastes like what a pumpkin spice cake should taste like. It's actually amazing to see how gluten-free foods have progressed over the years. I have had some really, really bad ones early on when they first started doing it. So they've really come a long way, and there are so many products out there. And so just saying that, like, you know, people with celiac disease or people who just don't want to eat gluten, they can still enjoy their favorite fall foods and not have to worry about paying for it. So if you have tried any fun gluten-free foods that you think that would be interesting for us to try, if you just want to hear my opinion on it, since I have had quite a few foods, just let me know in the comment section down below. I am totally open to trying it, especially because if it's something my mom doesn't know about and I try it and it's good, I can recommend it to her. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I know this wasn't super exciting, but maybe it's informative to people out there who do have that issue and are looking for some fun gluten-free foods to try. We will see you guys next week for another Taste Test Tuesday. Hopefully it'll be a little bit more exciting than this one. Hey Del, thank you for watching this even though it wasn't that exciting. If you're not Del, don't worry about it. It's just a secret mess. It's not secret because it's not secret. I can't do a secret message. We're gonna go lay down. It's been a very long day. We'll see you guys next week.